Your hand and use the back of your arm here, your tricep, down and up. So this is the hand I want the majority of the weight in. The other one is really just to support, but you will feel some work there too. Waistline is feeling this too. 6, 5, the diamond shape. Back and forward, back and forward. Up, 3 more. Down, out, in, up. 2, down, out, in, 2, 3, 3, lift your butt, 1, 2, 3, sit forward, 3 of these, 1, 2, 3, back in line. Keep your shoulders down, your tummy's pulled in, so you're rotating your shoulders. And you're just moving those weights slightly in front of you. You can see how they're just moving away. Knees, then come up onto your toes and 2 on your toes. Now these are tough, so if you can't do them on your toes, just stay on your knees. The key is that your elbows need to go towards the back. And flat. And push those weights up as if you're stamping the number on the ceiling. So you're going to bring your arms in close and just row to the back. Fast movement. The emphasis is on the up, so the elbow up at the back, and you really need to squeeze that same muscle, the upper back. Deep breaths. Now wider angle with those raises. So you're about 45 degrees out. And then come back, 40 seconds. Now, if it's too hard for you to touch up like this, then don't do it. You can just put your leg out and extend your arm. You don't have to touch up. So slow out on the exertion and make sure your tummy's pulled in tightly. You can even squeeze your glutes a bit in order to give you more stability there. And it's up and it's down. And it's down and it's up and it's down. It's a chest press. It's safely come up and scoop down. It's a fly. It's a chest press. Think about squeezing your chest, and it's a scoop across. 3, 4, down. 1, 2, 3, 4, up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Your core engaging here as well. 4. And in, once again, all the way out and in. 48, 49, and 50. Ah, you can kneel on this one. 12, so keep your knee down. 13, 14, 8, 29, 30, 31. Down. Then you're coming down. Tapping your elbow, tapping your elbow, keeping it really in line with your body. You need to make sure your alignment is perfect here. Together, so we're gonna make like a little V or a diamond shape here, and we're gonna go press, press, up, down. Press, press, up, down. 4, again, in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out, keep it out, 25 seconds. 3, 3, bring it in and out. 25. Quick reps will burn out the muscle even more. Breathe through it. Oxygen to the muscle. 29. Out. So squeeze and push. Around and push. You're not gripping your weights too tightly here. Around. Behind. They're not coming in front. They're not swinging. No. Stay in the zone and press back and back. Back, up, up. Your palm is to the back this time. 10, 9. But we're feeling our chest like crazy, yes? 19, 18. Just keep going. Down and up. Down and up. Go for 6, 5, a little bit off the mat. or you might want to come all the way up. So it's back, stretch, forward, and up. Then release that. Then bring your arm behind you so that your fingers are touching your back. And then just very lightly push your elbow back and your hand into your back. So you should be feeling an opening up all through that shoulder region. Bend the knees so you get a better grip, you can do that. So curve your spine away, opening up through your shoulder blades. So it's one, so it's exactly what we did when we had the lighter weight. Go back to bicep, this is two. Up, up. This in, out, straight arm up. Your palms are facing each other here. And then down. It's up, forward, back, goalposts, elbows in and down. Try and keep it fluid. Up, squeeze, forward, back, goalposts, elbows in and down. Up, in, down, up. Are you feeling this? Up, halfway down, up, in, down, up. Four more. Up, halfway down, up, in, down, up. Shoulders. So when your arms up in front, we're going to come in and up. In and up. Keep breathing, not many more. Four. Tension of the arm. The top portion is completely still. Eight, seven, six, five. Squeeze a lot harder than these tiny little weights. So imagine you're holding on to 10 kilo weights or even heavier, and you have to force it in with isometric motion. Good thing you're using more muscle fibers. 10 seconds, feeling your lower body too, that's a bonus. Other side in that little lunge position. If every now and then you need to tap your toe down, just like I did because I lost my balance, then that's totally fine too. Make it your workout as long as it's challenging. 11. Getting our hands all the way to the mat at the top and at the bottom so that we're creating that nice posture. And we love compound exercises because they shape up our entire body and also burn more calories by getting the heart rate up higher. This one burns out and in. Really try to keep that O shape or that diamond shape as you push out and in.